Norway, their wealth fund. They said they were going to go big in equities. They went big in equities, 70%. And you know what? There were some consequences, at least in this quarter.
There were, although, like, the number is very big. So $22 billion, it looks huge, but actually it's a small loss for them. It's 1.5% drop, so they actually have outperformed the market. Yes, they've got big in equities. The point of the fund, obviously, is to diversify Norway away from oil because that's where so much of their revenue comes from. And they're moving to, I think their target is to have 70% of the fund globally in equities and then a lot in bonds. And then they've also got the right to raise their real estate exposure to 7%, which would make them, I think, one of the biggest real estate owners in the world if they hit that target.
Yeah, but that's the point for me. The lack of money that they've got in alternatives. And I've spoken to them twice and said to them, how can you only have 2.7% in real estate and the sheer weight that they've got right now in bonds and equities? For me, it's a conundrum, quite frankly. They're huge and a different mix here perhaps would work for them better.
You should be a CIO.
Potentially. That's a real pitch. Guys, I'm here.
I'm sold.
at the same time, how do they get their money? From oil. Yeah. What's happened to the price of oil? Yes. They're probably not hurting all that badly.
They're not hurting all that badly. But, they, you know, look, longer term, their whole plan was to diversify away
totally.
From that.
In fact, I think, didn't they say they would not invest in any energy companies?
Right, yes. In any physical
stuff. Quite specifically.
Yeah. Very specifically. And they've also, they're long in some of the stocks that have been hurt. So they're long a lot of the big tech stocks. I think they're big in Amazon, they're big in Google, et cetera. So they, you know, they've done well over time and I'm sure will continue to do well, but they've just, in this recent quarter, they have been
lost 2.2% on stocks, 0.4% in bonds, and real estate provided 2.5% gain.
But if they were in Amazon, they might have gotten a little bit of it back
yeah,
in the last 24 hours, right?
Come on, guys.
That investment's looking
maybe the story's already out.
Exactly right. Yeah. Might not get it.